Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, database management system is triggers. So in the previous videos, I'll explain about the PL by SQL concept with an example with a program. Now let us see what is a trigger. Actually, a trigger is nothing but it is a procedure that starts. When this procedure will start, that start automatically if specified changes occur to the DBMS. So whenever you want to changes, you want to made a changes in the table, whenever you want to changes, made a changes in the database management system, this trigger will be introduced. So this trigger is nothing but it is a procedure that starts automatically if specified changes occur to the database management system. So this trigger concept, this trigger procedure will be written at the starting of the PL by SQL program. Or the structured query language program. So whatever you have taken, okay. So at the starting of that, you are just introducing the trigger. So whenever the program it starts, it automatically triggers that program. Means some changes have to be occurred in the program. That will be indicated by the trigger. Giving some disturbance, means just like if you want to insert or if you want to update or if you want to delete something in the table, you're just triggering the program by saying you are going to be insert the values, you are going to be update the values in the table. So that will be done by the trigger. So a database trigger is a stored procedure like PL by SQL program unit associated with a specific database tables. Okay, and the Oracle executes, so just executes or the fires a database trigger automatically when a given SQL operation like insert, update, delete affects the tables. Okay, so now let us see the different three parts that are present in the database triggers. Database triggers has three parts. That procedure, that trigger is having three parts. So one is trigger event, next trigger condition, and next trigger action. So these are the three parts that are present in the database trigger: event, condition, action. So event, whenever the event, trigger event is occurred, that have to be right at the starting of the program, and you have to mention the condition. So this condition will be an optional. Why it is an optional? So this condition is test whether the trigger should run or not. Okay, so whether the trigger should run or not will be tell by this condition. And what this trigger action will do, so it performs all the what type of changes that had to be made on the database table, that will be done by this action. So when an event occurs, first the database trigger is fired, means execute, and an predefined PL by SQL block will perform the necessary actions. Let me write that point. When an event occurs, the database trigger, so event means it is anything like update, delete, insert, like that. So when an event is occur, the database trigger is fired, means executed, and an predefined PL by SQL block will perform necessary action. Okay, so this is a basic definition of the trigger. Now let us see the syntax of the trigger. Let's see the syntax. Okay, so create, or you have to write replace. So here I'm writing event trigger. So the first part is event, next is condition, after that action. Create or replace trigger, and you have to mention the trigger name. Trigger name, and that can be done before or after. It indicates the trigger timing. Before or after trigger event on table name, on particular table, means on which table you want to do that modifications. So trigger event on table name. So that can be done for each row. This tells the row labels and when condition. Okay, so this is a trigger procedure. Create, condition, and action. When action for each rows. Now I'll write PL by SQL program. Declare. Declaration statements you have to write here. And after that, begin the program. So after write the begin, you have to write the executable statements. And if any exceptions is occurred in the program, write the exception handling block, exception handling statements, and the program. So this is the syntax for the trigger. So everything is just like PL by SQL, declare, begin, exception, end. So this is common for all PL by SQL. So the only thing here is you have to include the trigger procedure. So trigger procedure is, so in this procedure, the statements will be divided into three. First, an event is occurred, after that the condition, after that it performs the action. Okay, so this I'll explain with an example in the next video. Thank you.